Hi blender fans, and welcome once again to Blender TC. Have you ever created that texture that you didn't want to lose, but you always do because you can never remember all the settings that you actually created to make that texture? This is a Blender tutorial where I'm going to show you never lose a texture again. As you can see, what we've got here, we've got polyhaven, and of course polyhaven's famous for its HDR eyes and it's textured, but it's also got a model section now. As you can see, if we actually click on the textures, we've got 480 fully fledged textures with all sorts of things. So if we actually just click on one of these textures, as you can see, it's got all sorts of things. It's got bump, AO, diffuse, and of course normal maps, and the other things that make something like a texture come to life in your scenes. So you can actually create these textures and never lose a texture again. As you can see, we've actually clicked on this one, and this one's a rock face, and it's called Rock Face 3. So I'm just going to actually click on here. What you can do is actually pick the resolution you want to download, and you got 1K, 2K, 4K and 8K, and of course each one gets bigger and bigger, but 4K should be good enough for what you want to use. I'm going to download this. Now this downloads this into a zip file, and I've got most of my textures saved onto a separate hard drive because they are quite big. So as what I've done is I've got a portable D drive, Blender Work and 00 textures. So I'm going to download this compress file into this area, so save. So once it's actually downloaded, what we can do is actually open this in a location. So I'm just going to go to Rock Face, and it's quickly and easily opened this in Blender. So I'm just going to step up one, and as you can see, it's still a compressed file. So first, what we need to do is extract this. So double click on it and extract all. I'm just going to actually click on this extract all button, and as you can see, it's going to extract it. To Blender Work, where the textures are, under a thing called Rock Face for Blend. So extract, and as you can see, if I drag this across, it's extracted the textures, and of course we open these up, and here's all the maps that are needed. This one's the normal map. I don't know how it does this, but the normal map's there, but it's a bit hard to see, so I'm just going to actually backtrack one. So what also you've got in this file is you've got a Blender file, which is very helpful if you're in Blender. So I'm just going to double click on this just to open this file, and as you can see, I've got this open in Blender 4, and if I go on to actually rendered, we'll see that the actual rock texture should be applied to our sphere. There we go, and as you can see, this has got all the distortion maps and everything we need in our scene. So what I'm going to do is actually make sure that we've got an add-on installed. So I'm going to go to File, in fact Edit, Preferences, go to our add-ons, and what we're going to do is we're going to put MAT. Now this add-on comes with Blender already, so Matter, and if this is not already enabled, you've got Material Master Library, which is what we're going to actually save our library in. So what we're going to do is actually enable this, so save preferences, and then we'll close it. So we've got this new texture, as you can see, and of course it does distortion maps a lot better. As you can see, that there appears to be actually sticking out because it's actually using the distortion maps that Cycles does so well. So we've got that. And if you want to actually use this texture in another scene, what we can actually do is actually click on it. And first of all, you've got to actually save this. I don't know why, but you just have to. Just save it once again before you actually add this into a texture. So I've got this selected, and go down to your texture. Right, we never want to lose this texture again, so go into a material library. I've created a few libraries, and one of them I think is called Rock. So I'm just going to actually look to my library, go on to rocks, and as you can see, my rocks contains no nothing in there, and I'm just going to put add to library. There we go, we've got rock face 3. So this actually applies to your own texture. So you make a texture that you think, you think, great, that's one I really need to keep, and you can add this just the same way that we've just done to your own texture. So I'm just going to actually shut this down, just save it, just actually make sure that it sticks. So I'm just going to open another Blender scene, and of course this is going to be the default one, which is just the cube. So we've got the cube here, and what we can do is add a library to this, add a material. So we've added a material, and I'm just going to scroll down here. You might have to enable this back in your add-ons preference, like set add-on preferences, and you put material if it's not already a default in your scene. But of course it is in mine because I use this all the time now. So, and just save preferences. Right, so we've got this, and the material that we created under the rocks we can actually access quite simply by adding material, selecting my textures, but then we're going to go to the rocks, and of course miraculously this should have appeared in our rocks. I'm just waiting for it. All it's doing is actually loading this from where we saved it to, so it actually accesses the original file just to actually pull the actual texture back out of that. So if we actually click on our rock face 03 and then we apply to selected, wait a couple of seconds, and as you can see it's applied our rock texture to this. And of course, like I said before, this works better in cycles. So if you go in cycles, you will get a lot better actually result, and just wait for it to catch up. And as you can see, we've not lost our texture, and we've added this into our new cube. Now as you can see, there's not a lot of distortion in this, and the reason is because this is a flat face on all these sides, there's not enough topology to actually alter to make this a more realistic thing. So what we do is actually press the tab key, A to select all, and subdivide this. And I'm going to subdivide this by 100, like that. And if we go back out of edit mode and switch to Eevee and back to cycles and going to rendered, we should see that the actual rock texture is now fully applied into our scene, like that. As you can see, it's using the distortion from the actual texture, and I think this might even work in Eevee as well. Let's just go into Eevee. Not so good in Eevee, so it seems to really work much better in cycles. And as you can see, we've got the roughness actually being created for a realistic texture, and it's really reflecting the light. So don't ever lose a texture again in Blender. What you can do is actually create them using the materials library. And just lastly, if you want to actually preview what a material actually looks like, what we've got up here is preview, and it shows you what the actual texture would actually look like in real life if you wished. And of course there is 480 so far, and this is an ever-growing natural list that is through Polyhaven. Of course they're free to use, and they're free to use in your work, and you don't have to give attributions even if it's commercial work. So thanks to the people at Polyhaven, they're doing a fantastic job and helping us on our journey in 3D. Right, I really appreciate people watching to the end, and if you found this interesting, so thank you for actually joining me on Blender TC. And of course this means that you'll never lose a texture again, and as you can see it's a really, really good effect. please join me in the future on Blender TC. Bye for now.